Next, the Obama administration today took steps in this country to protect lions in Africa under the Endangered Species Act. Jeffrey Brown has that.
The U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service listed Central and West African lions as endangered, generally prohibiting importation of lion trophies from that region into the U.S. Lions in southern and eastern Africa are now classified as threatened, which will allow U.S. trophy imports only under certain conditions. The move comes 5 months after an American hunter killed a lion named Cecil outside a national park in Zimbabwe, and almost 5 years after U.S. conservation groups petitioned for greater protections for lions. For more, I'm joined by Daniel Ashe, director of the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service, and welcome to you.
Thank you, Jeff.
Why now is it right to see the killing of Cecil as a kind of game changer that galvanized public attention and now government action?
Well, we've been considering the listing of the lion for more than 5 years. We were petitioned under the Endangered Species Act, so that's been our responsibility. And we proposed listing the lion back in October of 2014 before the controversy over Cecil the lion. But Cecil and that controversy certainly has galvanized public emotions about lion and I think brings us to where we are today.
Advocacy groups had wondered what took so long.
Well, we are a scientific organization, and we're dealing with what many scientists call the sixth mass extinction. So we have many, many priorities, a lot of work under the Endangered Species Act. This is one of those things. And we have had lots of comment and lots of science to pour through.
Why would a U.S., explain this to people, why would a U.S. law or a designation have such a big impact on what happens in Africa, and in what ways would it have an impact?
Well, it's one of the great successes of the U.S. Endangered Species Act is that it projects U.S. leadership into world conservation. The economy of the United States oftentimes causes species extinction and decline, but in this case, we can use the power of the U.S. economy and our position as a trade leader to influence conservation of species like the lion.
Explain the distinction that I mentioned here between the reasons for the distinction between putting some lions on the endangered list, some on the threatened list.
So the law allows us to protect subspecies as well as species, and so the science tells us that there are two species of lion. One, the Asiatic, what used to be considered the Asiatic lion, is closely related to lions in northern and Western Africa, and then another distinct subspecies in southern and eastern Africa.
But why not go further? I mean, why not go further with the other species?
Well, the one species, the Panthera leo-leo, is only 900 of them remain in the wild, so severely endangered and in very small populations. The other subpopulation, leo melanchida, is there are about 17 to 20,000 of them in the wild, so they're in better condition, and some of those populations have actually been increasing during the last decade.
Well, that raises the question, how dire is the population problem? What is the real problem here at the core?
Well, at the core of this problem is human conflict with lions. So we're seeing humans and human economies occupying the same habitat that lions need to prosper. And so as populations increase and become more affluent in Africa, we're seeing more conflict with lion. And so the future for lion is bleak at this point in time, and we could be looking at a future where there is nothing called a lion in the wild unless we take important actions, and that's what we're doing today.
The hunting industry, of course, has argued for a long time that A, hunting can be controlled, and B, that the money that comes from these hunts provide resources for conservation in countries that often do not have enough money, enough funds.
And that argument in general is a good argument, and we see that here in the United States, where hunting, well-regulated and managed hunting, can ensure prosperous wildlife populations. But I think in Africa, and as we think about the plight of the lion and the drastic declines that we've seen, I like to think of a Zimbabwean proverb that says, until the side of the lion can be told, the story of the hunt always glorifies the hunter. And what we need to do in the United States is we need to do better. The United States needs to do better and can do better. The hunting industry needs to do better and can do better. And the American hunter in particular needs to do better and can do better. And our listing today, we think, is going to provide that kind of incentive.
Daniel Ashe, the director of the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service. Thanks so much.
Thank you, Jeff.